Hi, I'm Kruno. Thanks for watching EPLAN Essentials. Have you ever wondered how to open doors in EPLAN Pro Panel? This is a very frequently asked question, which I'm going to cover in this video. When you want to open doors in EPLAN Pro Panel, you need to know two things. First, in which direction are you opening the door? And second, what is the axis you are rotating around the door? The first thing is pretty easy. If you take a look at this door, you see the handle is on the left side and the hinges are on the right side. That means we are opening the door counterclockwise. A better view we will have if we go to view 3D viewpoint top. In this case, we know the handle is on the left side, the hinges are on the right side. So we are opening the door in this direction. Therefore, the angle will be a negative angle. The second question was what is the axis we are rotating around? And in this case, we see the blue axis is the axis which we are rotating around, because the blue axis will be here and it will be stiff while we are rotating the door around. So now we know the axis and that the angle will be negative. With this, we'll start the rotation of the door. For this, I'm going to, again, to the southeast isometric view. Now I'm going to select the door. We know that the door is part of the enclosure, therefore we will have to press the shift button while selecting it. And now we're going to go to edit, rotate around the axis to start to rotate the door. So we learned before the Z axis, the blue axis is the axis which we're going to rotate the door around. Therefore, now we just need to select the edge which points in that direction. I'm going to select this one here. The next point, you can just select any point to specify the direction of the rotation. It really does not matter, but the rotation angle matters. So we learned before that the angle will be negative. So now whatever angle you would like to open the door, you just have to enter a negative value. Let's, for instance, say I would like to open the door 45 degrees, so I'll enter minus 45. And as you now see, the door was opened. On a first view, if I look from the top, the result may not be satisfying, but if you know what you're going to do next, the result is exactly what you needed. So the door was opened, it was rotated around the point of gravity, and it was not moved in the Z axis. Only the X and Y axis got moved. Therefore, we know that if we now move the door in the X and Y axis, we will point it on the exact position. Okay? And this is actually pretty easy, because now we just need to measure the distance from this point here to the point where it tops on the hinge. Okay? And to figure this out, in the second step, we will just use the measure functionality. Select a point which will help us, in this case, this specific point. And I'm going to zoom in and select this point. Here you see now the dx and dy. So that means that the delta in the x-axis and the delta in the y-axis from the start point to the end point. I'm just going to write those two values down. X is minus 33.33. Y is minus 334.91. Now, knowing those values, we can close the measuring window. Select the door again, holding the shift button while selecting the door. And now we can use the V button for moving the door and control V for the placement option. If we now enter with reference to original position and enter the two measured values, min minus 33.33 and minus 334.91 and press OK. The door is moved on the position where we want it. So if I take a look now from the 3D viewpoint southeast, the door is open 45 degrees. If you open it from a southeast isometric view, it's also correct. The only thing what we need now to consider is that all surfaces were rotated by 45 degrees. That means also this routing path need to be realigned. I'm just gonna, in this exercise, delete the routing path. Let's take a look how the result will appear in model views. So here we have the model view created, and under tools, update, oh, I need this. You see, the model view were updated with the open door now visible. This wraps up today's EPLAN Essentials video. If you found it useful, please make sure to like and subscribe to the channel. Have you ever used the open door functionality, or will you use it in the future? Let me know in the comments. Until the next time, Uncle Kruno signed out.